Israel now claims to have found documents on the bodies of dead Hamas terrorists detailing how to make chemical weapons. It's a terrifying new development among many. Israel's closest allies, especially America, fear this war could soon explode into a full-scale Middle East conflict and are now arming themselves to help defend the Jewish state.
With so much emphasis and fear over the planned ground invasion of Gaza, for now this war continues to be fought largely from the air, non-stop. And today, Israel's bombing of Gaza intensified. And so did the misery. Neighbours dig for survivors with small garden tools. Like so much here, it seems hopeless, but not even trying is more unbearable than what they might find. This family of seven was killed at dawn and buried by sundown. And these children only survived after being given to a reporter who rushed them to hospital. It is relentless and beyond cruel. This doctor found his father and brother among the dead who were brought to his emergency ward, allowing himself just a moment before returning to his sworn mission, saving the lives of others.
I couldn't believe when I saw them. I couldn't even tell them apart at first. Despite how hard it is, despite the complete destruction of my house and the death of my family, I will continue my work until my last breath.
Israel's president visibly angry when asked to defend his country's actions today.
Guys, it's very easy to blame Israel. Let's just remember where we were, what happened, and how do we have the right to defend ourselves when a missile that flies 250 kilometers straight into Israel comes from people's living room. That's the situation we're faced with.
Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is unflinching. He met with troops again today, telling them this war will crush Hamas forever. A matter of life and death, he tells them. Few needed reminding of that. Certainly not America, which has never been more blunt about the prospects of a wider war with Israel's other enemies in the region, especially in Lebanon and the Iranian-backed Hezbollah on the northern border region.
If any group or any country is looking to widen this conflict and take advantage of this very unfortunate situation that we see, our advice is don't.
From Mr. Netanyahu, we will strike with a force Lebanon cannot imagine. But there's a growing sense that it's already too late. Iran's foreign minister calling the region today a powder keg, warning Israel that if it enters Gaza, it will suffer a bitter and heavy consequence.
We expect that there's a likelihood of escalation.
Today, the U.S. also ordered all non-essential staff out of Iraq.
Recently, we've seen rocket and UAV attacks against bases housing our troops in Iraq and Syria.
The United States and Britain also confirming they're shipping more weapon systems to the region, including missile defense systems like Israel's famed Iron Dome, protecting not just from Hamas rockets, but the threat of hostile nations.
Patriot and THAAD systems positioned in secret locations, just as Israel revealed the weapons in this war could be far from conventional. Terrifying new evidence found on the body of a Hamas fighter from the Israeli president.
In this material, there were instructions how to produce chemical weapons.
Specifically, cyanide. The claims not independently verified, but a nightmare scenario. Just as a trickle of hope arrived in the south. More aid trucks are now entering the Gaza Strip through Egypt. This V is for a very small victory. It's nowhere near enough for the tsunami of civilians who fled south and are now trapped in a human bottleneck on the border. Among them, 77 Australians, a higher number than Canberra first thought. The UN anticipates they'll be out of fuel by midweek, just as disease and hunger take over. And it's not just the Israeli military preparing for more bloodshed, civilians are too. In the 2 weeks since the Hamas terrorist attacks on innocent Israelis, there's been a surge in gun ownership.
A lot of people here also in Israel didn't expect that. They didn't expect that it will come to your house.
October 7 has fundamentally changed the country. Israelis taking personal security into their own hands.
We even have like 60, 70 years old people that come and take out firearms. We have mothers that come here. We're preparing for war. War means more bullets, bigger guns.
At the gun shop here, there's almost a crowd crush, a firearms free-for-all.
And you've never seen it like this before?
No, it's been so busy.
This man can't wait to get his gun home. It's on his hip and hidden under his shirt before leaving the shop. 41,000 people here have applied for a gun license, more in a fortnight than would normally apply in a year.
You need more magazines. Here I can put two magazines, another one on me.
Guns to go.
This is all about keeping people safe.
Yeah, wouldn't you want to be able to protect your family?
It feels like everyone here is now armed to the teeth, whether they're in uniform or not.
And Chief Reporter Chris Reason is in Tel Aviv for us once again. Chris, still no word on when the ground invasion of Gaza will take place.
Nothing yet, Mark. No. Good evening to you. There are two major forces acting against Israel's plans to invade Gaza. The first of them are the fears of major regional escalation. Syria, Iran, Hezbollah in Lebanon, all of them have been making noises about retribution if Israel does roll into Gaza. The world's leaders are doing everything they can to stop a broader Middle East war. Right now, the diplomatic back channels are alive with negotiation. The phone lines are running hot. The second force that's pushing back against the tanks rolling into Gaza are those hostages, 212 of them from 30 countries. We know last night US President Joe Biden rang into the Prime Minister here, Benjamin Netanyahu, begging for more time to get them out. Also, the families and supporters of those hostages, well, they've become a diplomatic force in their own right. The question will be, how much longer will Benjamin Netanyahu listen to them? Mark?
Such a crucial question. Chris Reason in Tel Aviv. Thank you. To make matters worse for families of hostages, Hamas has begun tormenting them. Many distraught relatives have been sent photos of their captured loved ones.
Oh, wow.
Shani.
A mother showing pictures of her daughters, now hostages of Hamas. Daphna and her 8-year-old sister Ella snatched 2 weeks ago.
We will not hear the child.
The terrified girls were with their father, his partner and her son when gunmen stormed in. Hamas live streamed on the partner's phone before murdering everyone but the girls.
They're tormenting you.
Maya Zinn says the terror group has sent her pictures of her daughters. She fears the unspeakable worst, but like others in this conflict, lives in hope.
Incredible sadness and worry.
A hope seen overnight in Switzerland, on the streets of America and in the heart of London. The names of the missing read out.
11 years old.
Israel saying tonight, there are 212 confirmed hostages. Missing or captive, they come from all over the globe. 7 from Britain, 7 from France, 8 Germans, Russia, India, Italy, Thailand is missing 19. It's likely they're all held in Gaza, possibly hidden inside hundreds of kilometres of Hamas tunnels. Here in Tel Aviv, they've set up an unofficial war room for hostage families.
So there's about 15 former diplomats. Are you all volunteering your time at the moment?
Of course. Yes. Everybody here is volunteering, the lawyers, the psychotherapists, the doctors, the social workers.
As the days and weeks go by, these families are pleading with the world not to forget about their loved ones, not to become desensitized by the horrors they've heard. There is both a sense of sorrow in this room, but determination too. Friday's return of two Americans giving hope, like the return of Gilad Shalit, an Israeli soldier held by Hamas for 5 years, reminders to never give up.
So do something now and help stop the next atrocity.
In Israel, Ashley Mullaney, 7 News.
Closer to home, a Jewish Australian businessman is trying to step up the pressure to have the hostages freed by Hamas. He's printing 10,000 posters to be placed around the city to raise awareness.
For us, the most important thing is to bring those people back home.
He's also hired a truck with electronic billboards to help spread the message. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has arrived in Washington for a meeting with US President Joe Biden. The visit will focus on the conflict in the Middle East, as well as the deadlock over the $300 billion AUKUS nuclear submarine deal.
The United States' relationship with Australia is our most important. In today's turbulent world, it is a relationship that provides security, stability.
The PM has cancelled a week of parliament while he's away.